So, hello friends, in today's lecture we will be continuing with the sensor materials and technologies. So in last lecture we have seen that the various materials that are used for sensor applications, so metals, then the ceramic materials, silicon, then plastic, glass. We have seen the how these materials are used for the sensors. So today we'll be continuing with the next technologies, that is related with the surface processing. Once you get such kind of materials or sensing materials, then how exactly the sensor is formed. So there are certain techniques by which you can manufacture the sensor. So we are going to see few of the techniques that are related with this one. So the first technique we are going to see, that the deposition of thin films and thick films. So we know that most of the time the material which you are using as a substrate material is not capable of having the sensing characteristics, or that will not give you the for example, the piezoelectric material. Silicon does not exhibit the piezoelectric effect. So to have this piezoelectric effect, you have to deposit a film on the surface of that silicon material. So in many of the applications, such kind of applications are there. So for such purpose, you have to deposit this thin film and thick film on the surface, and you have to process it. So before that, how to process the surface material, that we are going to see it. So the thin films are required to give the sensing surface some of some properties for a substrate which does not possess it. So I have given you the example of silicon, which does not possess the piezoelectric effect. So we need to have a piezoelectric film that need to be deposited on the surface. So here it is another example, that to enhance the absorption of the thermal radiation by far infrared, the surface may be coated with the material having the high absorbability. So nichrome has this absorbability, so it absorbs the far infrared type of thermal radiation. So you have to use such kind of thin films with the substrate. So piezoelectric film may be applied on the silicon wafer to give the piezoelectric properties. Then the thick films are often used to fabricate the pressure sensors and microphones. So the method to deposit the thin or thick film, there are three to four methods are there. So we are going to see one by one. Spin casting method is there, vacuum deposition method is there, then sputtering method is there, then electroplating method is there, and screen printing method is there. So these are the methods by which you can deposit a thin film on a substrate. So we are going to see the first method, that is called as a spin casting. Spin casting means, you know that whenever a circle moves, or whenever a material moves in a circular direction, or it has an angular velocity, then you know that if you put you can perform such kind of experiment at your home also. You take a disc, or you take one material on center, you put certain material which will be freely moving. You may put the water, you may put oil also. So better you take the high viscosity type of material, water, you take a oil, and simply rotate that material, that disc. What will happen? So because of this spinning, that material, because of centrifugal force, that material will try to move towards outside, and that will get spreaded. So this is the way how the spin casting will also takes place. So spin casting process involves the use of thin film material dissolved in a high volatile liquid solvent. So the solution is poured on a sample, and the sample is rotated at high speed. So the centrifugal force spread the material after the solvent evaporates, and the thin film of the thin layer of the film remains on the sample. So this technique is often used for deposition of organic material, especially for fabricating humidity and chemical type of sensors. So thickness of the that film depends upon the speed of the rotation, and
how you are pouring the material, that solubility of that material, that depends upon that one. So you can have the thickness in the range of 0.1 to 50 micrometer. So when the sample is non-flat surface, then your non-uniform film will be produced. So in many cases it is not expected, but for many applications it will be useful. So most of the time it is expected that the surface should be very flat one, then we'll get a uniform film. Then the second method is a vacuum deposition method. Second method is a vacuum deposition method. So there is a chamber which consists of vacuum, and in that vacuum you will be depositing a film from anode to cathode. So here metal can be converted into gaseous form and then deposited on the surface of the sample. So what will happen? The evaporation system consists of vacuum chamber, so where the diffuse pump evacuates air down. The pressure will be 10⁻⁶ to 10⁻⁷ torr. Then you can have deposit such kind of material on the sample. So deposited material is placed in a ceramic crucible which is heated by a tungsten filament or a electronic beam above the metal melting point. So the metal is kept, the film of which you want to deposit on the surface of the sample. So that metal is heated by this tungsten filament or electronic beam, and that will form into gaseous form, and that gaseous form will get deposited on the surface of the sample. So on the command of the control device, the shutter opens and the metal atoms get emitted and in the molten form and deposited on the sample. So the part of the sample which remains free in the that means which does not get deposited on the film, so that will be protected by the mask and that will be taken out by the vacuum pump. So the film thickness is determined by the evaporation time and the vapor pressure. So how much time you will keep that sample exposed to such kind of environment and what is the pressure you are putting on, that's two points will decide the thickness of the film. So if the time is more and pressure is accordingly, then the thickness will be more, and if the time is less, the thickness will be less. So this is how exactly you can see that here it is the metal. So in this crucible the metal is kept, molten metal is kept, and which is heated with either by electronic beam or a tungsten. Then the shutter is there, and this shutter is pulled to and fro. So when it is taken away, so because of the pressure and the gaseous form of this metal, so this will get deposited on this metal and this sample. And the sample is rotated because you want the uniformity in that one. Otherwise only deposition will take place at one place and other place it will not take place. So it will rotate at certain speed, so you can maintain the uniformity on that one. So this is how the vacuum deposition takes place. So the material is with low melting point are easy to deposit. For example, if you want to deposit the foil, the film of aluminium, you can easily deposit because aluminium is having low melting point. Then the vacuum deposited films have a large residual stress, and have this technique is mainly used for depositing the thin film. So if you are having a large residual stress, then in that case you will be using this technique for depositing the thin film. Then the multiple sources and rotating target reduces the shadowing effect. So shadowing effect means depositing at one place and another place. So that effect you can avoid it by having the multiple resources. That means instead of having only one multiple one source of metal, you can have a multiple source of metals and you can rotate it. So you rotating the target, you can reduce the shadowing effect. So spurious material which is already there in the chamber, that you need to take out initially, so that the chamber is vacuumized properly. Otherwise it is going to create a problem, or the film produced may not exhibit the property you are expecting. So that should be avoided initially. So initially you need to take it out, and whatever may be the residuals are there, that also you have to take it out. Okay, so this is a vacuum deposition process. So the next is the sputtering technique. The next technique of this surface processing is sputtering. Now what happens in sputtering? Sputtering, actually, instead of using the heater and the vacuumized temperature, so you can use the anode and cathode type of technique. So we know that you might have studied the diode type of vacuum diode type of device. So which consists such kind of structure. So here it is the anode, here it is the cathode, and here it is the anode which gets heated by the certain filaments. So when it gets heated by the filament, so the electrons, because of this thermal energy, the electrons will get attracted towards this. So here it will be connected to the positive battery, and here it is will be connected to the negative, and so on. So electrons will get attracted towards. So the same principle is used here. So high cathode voltage and anode voltage are applied for this one, and electrons will get multiplied by, because of collision, and that will get deposited on the surface of the sample. So the same principle is used over here. So here you can see that here it is the anode, and on that anode you have kept the sample. On that anode you have kept the sample. Now what will happen? So this is the cathode, is the target material you want to deposit. So what will happen initially when you give the supply, power supply to this one, and electrons, these sputtered atoms will get attracted towards this one. This will bounce over here, and that will again move the electrons towards this one, and that will induce a secondary emission on this one, and that will cause the ions to be deposited on this sample as a film. So the electrons and ions will form their film. So these ions which are in the form of these gases are there. So because of this power supply, these ions will get attracted towards this one. So there will be emission. So this sputtered atom will come on this anode, and there will be a secondary emission because of the collision. And because of that collision, so the film gets deposited of desired material. So after evacuation of air, the inert gas such as argon or helium is introduced in the chamber near about a pressure of 2×10⁻⁶ or 2×5×10⁻⁶ torr. So with such pressure, that gas is inserted in that chamber, and the power supply is applied to the cathode and anode, and accordingly the ions will be formed, and these ions will move, and they will create the secondary emissions or bombarding the ions, and these bombarded ions are get attracted towards the anode where the sample is kept, and that will form the film. So external high voltage DC or AC supply is attached to the cathode target. Target means the material which you want to deposit. So cathode is fabricated of the material which has to be deposited on the sample. So sample is attached to the anode. Now how a high voltage ignites the plasma in an inert gas, and the gas ions are bombard the target. So the kinetic energy of bombarding ions is sufficiently high to make the free some atoms from the surface target, and these atoms are escaped from the sputtered atom as a sputtered atoms and get deposited on the surface of sample. So the sputtered technique yields a better uniformity, especially if the magnetic field is introduced in a chamber. So if you have an external magnetic field which will control these electrons or ions that are depositing, allowing you to have a better control over these atoms towards the anode, and you will get a better uniformity as compared to the previous techniques. So any material including organic can be sputtered. So you can sputter any material. Sputter means first you have in a gaseous form, then ionization takes place, and ionization will free some electrons because of kinetic energy. So that technique is called as a sputtering technique. So the material from more than one target can be deposited at the same time. That is called as a co-sputtering. That means you can have two targets and they can be again used for sputtering purpose. So the technique is called as a co-sputtering, and that will be permitted a controlled ratio of the material. So you can combine the materials with the two targets. So useful for sputtering is generally a nichrome type of material, nickel and chromium. So that electrodes are on the surface of pyroelectric sensors. So generally nickel and chromium, that is called as a nichrome, that is an alloy which will be used for pyroelectric type of sensors. So these sensors will use such kind of sputtering technique. Then the next technique is chemical vapor deposition. So in chemical vapor deposition, that is called as a CVD type of technique. The process is important. Is a process which is an important technique for a production of optical, optoelectrical, and electronic devices. So if you want to develop such kind of optoelectronic devices, then such kind of CVD technique is very useful. So the sensor technologies, it is useful for forming the optical windows and fabrication of semiconductor sensors. This CVD is very useful. CVD takes place in deposition of a chamber, which is a reaction chamber. It is called as a reaction chamber. So here it is the example, what will happen. So here this is the substrate on which you have kept your samples. So these are the samples, wafers or the silicon wafers on which you want to put a thin film or thick film. So what will happen? So these is get heated so that you will maintain the temperature of your sample at a certain degree. So this substrate holder will maintain the temperature, and what will happen, this is a deposition chamber through which you are allowing a gas of depositing metal or material is to be passed. Then there is a distributor cone is there. So that distributor cone will pass this gas in such a way that it will move on the surface of the sample, and it will have a gas outlet from which it will exit. And this is how you are passing the gas, and that gas will deposit the required material on the surface of the silicon. So the substrate of the wafers are positioned on a stationary or rotating table whose temperature is evaluated up to the required level by the heating element. So the top cover of the chamber has an inlet to pass H2 gas, which can be added by the various precursors and dopants. So you into that H2, so we know that H2 is the inert gas. So in that you can add the dopants also. So that dopants will get deposited on the surface of this one. So these additives, while being carried over the heated surface or the substrate, form the film layer. So the gas mixture flows from the distribution cone over the top of the surface of the wafer and exit through the exhaust gas outlet. So the average gas pressure in a chamber may be near about one atom or somewhat lesser than that. So with that,
we came to the end of surface processing techniques. So in that we have seen the sputtering technique, chemical vapor deposition, then spinning type of technique, spin coating type of technique. So I hope these are the basic techniques. Apart from that, the screen printing technique is also there, where you have the screen of the material which you want to deposit. You simply put that ink of that metal on that screen and you simply print it on the surface of that one, and you heat it up to certain degree temperature, and after heating that one, that film gets formed on the surface of that material. That is called a screen printing technique. So the screen printing technique, it is similar to the printing of your paper or the printing of your visiting cards or your invitation cards and so on. The only thing is that the method is little bit different, but the process itself. Okay, so with that we came to the concept of end of the concept of techniques for surface processing. If you have any query, you can ask me the questions. I will try to answer your questions. Thank you very much. Now the next part is related to the nanotechnique that we are going to see it in a next lecture. Thank you.